Hello. Good evening. Hi, guys. Welcome to Monday night. Tonight is Monday night, July 13th, I think. 11th. I guess I don't really know what day of the week it is. I know it's Monday, but I don't really know the date. My name is Serena, and I am your outreach director at Resurrection. Tonight, I want to talk to you about some adventure stuff. I don't know about you, but we, when we get in the car and we have to drive anywhere, we play this game. I'm thinking of an animal. And so, I don't know if you've played this game, but it starts out like, oh, I'm thinking of an animal. And the questions are like, are you a herbivore or an omnivore? Are you native to North America? All of these sorts of questions. And I was thinking about that today. That if we think about those animals, we think about how scary some of them are. Like, most of the earth is not safe. If you think about all the animals, most of the earth is not safe, but it's still good. If we think about it, God created the lions and the jaguars, scorpions, the great white sharks, the silverback gorillas, the giant squids of the ocean. These are all like vicious carnivores. Like, they would attack, and we live life amongst them. He also made man and woman, and as we've seen over the last thousands of years, men and women are not very safe either. We make bad choices. We can be dangerous to ourselves and to others. But God created all of that. And when he was finished, Genesis 1 verse 31 says, God saw all that he made, and it was very good. So not only did God make us wild and free like the animals, like the silverback gorillas, but he made us to take risks, to have adventures, to enjoy the surprises that life has to offer to us. But how many of us fear those very things that God made us and created us to do? I mean, who else besides me does everything we can to reduce the element of surprise in our life? I mean, I plan everything. I plan everything. And when things don't go the way I planned or expected them to go, I get uptight, I get anxious, sometimes I have chest pains because this isn't how I planned life to be. I want to control my environment. I mean, we do things like wear our seatbelts and take our medications and go to the same restaurants and only eat certain foods and all of these things to have control in our lives. But is that really what God wanted us to do? Is that really how God made us? I mean, I am so type A that we oftentimes take the same family vacations. Now, I know this seems overdone. A little redundant. Like, really, how many times can you take your children to Wisconsin Dells and stay at the same resort in usually the same condo suite? Because we know it and it's comfortable and we feel safe. Even though it's an adventure and it's supposed to be a vacation and make new memories, and we do all of those things. But I've come to the point in my life that I still am only living in the safety of knowing things that I know. I fear what the world has to offer at times. Yes, I know. I've been to the Dominican, and that's scary for some. And it was scary, and it is scary. But you know what? When I trusted God to step out and do that and take that trip, it was so worth it. It opened my eyes to the world that I didn't even know existed. Because I was willing to take the risk and have faith that God had given me. I mean, I don't even try new foods or go to new restaurants. Like, I run the same path when I run. Not very often anymore. But when I run, I take the same path. Like, I'm such a creature of habit that I don't even look outside my box for an adventure. Or is it safety? I mean, when did our adventure-seeking times fade? Like, when did we decide that we were not strong enough or good enough to take leaps of faith? To just like try something new, and who knows, it might be the best thing we've ever done. But we're scared. Like, when did I lose that confidence? I don't know about you. And maybe some of you lost your confidence in adventure taking. If you lost your sense of adventure taking, I know I'm not the only one who has lost that. Did I do it when I became a mother? Like, was it the first time I came a mother or the second time I came a mother? Like, I'm not really sure when I lost that. Do you know when you lost your sense of adventure? Like, I feel like that's about when, because like I had more responsibility, and so I couldn't take adventures or seek out risks because there was more people counting on me. But is that really the world God created for you and I? Because I'm pretty sure that He created a world full of jaguars and lions and giant squid and octopus the size of my vehicle. Like, God put scary and adventurous things in our life for us to experience. And we can't hold on to the safety net. Like, yes, I get it. We need to be safe and we need to be cautious and we need to not like just jump out of an airplane without a parachute. I get that. And some of you have no fear when it comes to this, but I do. And new things scare me. But I'm finding that I need to be adventurous. God made and designed this world for us to live and take risks. Yes, He promised the world to us. He promised that if we believed in Him and if we shared the gospel and the whole earth could be ours, could be man's. That's what He promised Adam when they were left the garden, that they were to go and make the land would be theirs. That they would go and reproduce and have harvest and all of these things and these adventures that they didn't even know they were happening. But it's scary. But what if this is the world God made? A world that requires us to live with risk. We need to live in faith, really. That's how we jump out of our comfort zone and live in confidence in those risks. Because it's not God, it can't. Oh, God can. Scratch that. We can only do so much. It is us and our free will that holds us back. Our doubt that He's really going to hold on to us the way that He promises. And so we know that the world is unsafe and scary at times. We know that. We've been living that. I mean, I don't know one other time besides living in the jungle with real life jaguars, which is what my kids call them, jaguars. That's scary. But we have lived through a global pandemic, racial injustices, rioting, boycotting, all of this, the sense of unknown and fear right here in the last 4 months, maybe more. And we have to be willing to lean into God, take the risk of faith, and pray. And if He opens up the doors for an adventure, to take it. To take it. I'm looking forward to new adventures. I'm looking forward to stepping out of my comfort zone. I'm looking forward to all the things that this is burning inside me, that God is stirring inside my soul to help me experience the life full of risks that He has created. And if I lean into Him and listen for His discernment, I'll know, and so will you. So, what are some adventures you're ready for? It could be your kids are leaving the home, and that's a new adventure. It could be downsizing because you no longer need that large house that raised your kids. It could be a big move or job changes or not going back to school. Like, what is the adventure? And we can look at it as not an adventure, as a struggle or a downfall, but it's an adventure and it's a time for us to stand firm into the promises that God made for us. That if we lean into Him and trust Him and listen, that we are going to enjoy this life and be able to see and try new things. But we need to have faith that He's got it. Pray with me. Lord, I pray for adventures. I pray that you lead us and guide us to the path, Lord. You have this laid out for us, Lord. And sometimes we get into our own heads, into our own wanting to control our lives, that we hold on so tight, Lord, that we don't let you use us in the ways that you have planned for us, Lord. Lord, use me. Use me to spread the gospel in ways that I could have never dreamed. Lord, use me to help serve others, Lord, when I was too scared and timid to step out of my bubble. Lord, encourage us all to live adventurous and take risks. Lord, to not be afraid of the animals that we think of when we're playing. I'm thinking of an animal with our family. Be with us in our week. I can't wait to see what the week has for all of us. Be with us in your holy name, we pray. Amen. Amen, guys. Thanks for joining me tonight. We'll see you again tomorrow night. Good night.